It's a big day here at the AMEX Stadium as it hosts its first full senior international. England women take on Montenegro in a World Cup qualifier. England go into this game, they've won all four games, Montenegro have lost all four of their games. So on paper, foregone conclusion. But there's two big things coming out today. Mark Sampson, the coach, is his first game on home soil. And Steph Houghton, just been named England captain, leads the team out for the very first time.
Big day today. Tell us what's going on around here, though.
It's just the fan zone, you know, all the kids are coming down, getting involved. We're just promoting women's football, you know, trying to get them interested in it, getting involved.
How important are events like this to get more girls to play football?
It's really important, really. Just some girls might come along, not done it before, quite like it, they enjoy it. Get involved, it's just to promote it, really.
What do you like about girls football? Do you play it yourself?
I do.
Yeah, who do you play for?
I play for Gosport FC Girls.
Oh, this is your team, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. What position do you play?
I play left back.
It sounds simple, but what are the challenges to get more girls to play football?
Well, women and girls football is the biggest female team sport in this country, and it's come along a huge way. And I think it's really important that girls get a chance to play in schools and get an introduction to the sport like they would probably other more traditional female sports like netball and hockey. And that's happened more and more. Most schools now will provide girls football. And we've got a great network of clubs and leagues providing football for girls and young women across the country. So it's growing and growing.
Today we're having like a skills session. So basically it's a free session where I teach all the tricks I know to the kids.
And what do you do? How do you know all these tricks?
Because I'm a professional freestyler, so I travel the world doing tricks. That's my job.
Can you tell me why you're here today?
To watch the England match.
And is it the England ladies game today?
Yes.
And what are you looking forward to the most?
To watching them win.
How is it with girls football at the moment? Is it looking good? Is it getting better?
Yeah, it's up and coming. It's going really well, to be fair. It's lifted off in the last couple of years really well.
So, yeah, okay. Definitely. Like I've said before, when I was younger, there weren't that many opportunities out there for girls, but it's just taken off last couple of years, and it's just great.
And how are the girls getting on? Have you seen some good skills today?
Yeah, I've seen some really good skills. I think girls like now just get more and more into football because we've got events like this and got an opportunity to try whatever they want to do.
Where did you learn everything you know? How did you decide? I want to be a freestyler.
I used to play professionally back home in Norway because I'm from Norway. So I used to play there and just always practice skills like seeing adverts on telly and things like that when I was little, and then sort of just the ball rolled on from there.
And events like today really, you know, important and inspiring young women who maybe might not have been aware previously there was a pinnacle right at the top that you could play for England, travel the world and be an elite athlete.
So the participation levels were quite high here this morning at the Amex Stadium. The game itself was indeed a foregone conclusion, 9-0 to England. Toni Duggan getting a hat-trick in that game. That makes it 5 out of 5 for Mark Sampson's team. On they go to Ukraine.